everybody. I'm Luke Burl here with Hayward Area Memorial Hospital in Water's Edge, and I have the opportunity today to sit down with three of our local physicians to talk about COVID-19. There's a lot of misinformation and information out there, and I think we owe it to our local communities to help clarify some of the things that we can be doing to protect ourselves and our community during this uncertain time. So I'm going to let each of our physicians introduce themselves and then talk to you about what you can do to keep your community safe.
Hi, I'm Matt Ledke, one of the physicians at Essential Health.
Hi, I'm Dr. Katie Eichten, and I'm an ER doc here in Hayward, and I also work in the ER in Spooner, and I'm a mom of three young kids.
Hi, I'm Sabrina Dunlap. I am a physician at North Lakes Community Health Center. I'm also the medical advisor for the Sawyer County Health Department, and I have two teenagers, 16 and 18.
So let's start with Dr. Ledke. Dr. Ledke, what can you do, as a community member, what can we do to keep our community safe?
Well, as we're talking about community, one of the things people probably know or have observed when they go to the store, the shelves are getting bare. One of the things I think we really need to look at is the amount of supplies that we are stockpiling. The guidance right now is that you stockpile 2 weeks worth of food and other necessities such as hand sanitizer and toilet paper. And have 30 days worth of medication if you are on medication. I think we need to follow that seriously, as if we overstockpile, that means that there are others who are going to be denied access to these necessities and therefore going to put them at risk. And if we have people that are at risk in our community, it's going to mean that everybody within the community is at risk. So please, we understand you need to stock up, but do so in a reasonable way so that everybody can get this, the necessities that they need also.
Awesome. Dr. Eichten?
I guess I would say is stay home and follow the distancing recommendations. We're following the recommendations here. We're trying to be aware of that. We want to decrease our spread by, limiting our interactions with other people, staying in small groups. Like, we can slow the spread of this virus, and if we can slow the spread of the virus, we will actually save lives. Not only that, but you'll help us to take better care of people. If they, people get sick more slowly, we have a better chance of taking care of people. If everyone gets sick at once, that's a lot of people for us to try to take care of. So the more we can stay away and spread out and stay home, the better chance that we have. So help us in that, please.
And Dr. Dunlap?
So when we're talking about how do you keep your community safe if you can't be with them, and I would challenge everybody to define their community. Is their community their family, their neighbors, their grandparents? Be in touch with them by phone. Be in touch with them by technology. Text them, call people. Listen to their stories, because everyone has an amazing story, and it's incredibly therapeutic to share those stories. In Italy, apparently, they are singing to each other across the streets, and I don't recommend that in my neighborhood, but being aware of other people who might be at risk and checking in on them every day by phone would be a great way to start with keeping our community safe.
Excellent. So there you have it from three of our great providers in the Hayward area. I just want to let everybody know that we are working on planning efforts community-wide, public health. We had LCO representation at our medical staff meeting last night, working with our local clinics to make sure that our response, no matter what effort it has to mount to, is ready and prepared to keep you safe. Things we're working on right now are trying to set up outlets for community curbside testing and figuring out the logistics of that. And I would point to our website at the hospital here, haywardareamemorial.com. haywardareamemorialhospital.com, as well as our Facebook site to get the most up-to-date information. So be safe. Please take these recommendations seriously, and thanks for listening.